Back to the universal God. And I'm here talking to folks who know you universal. I came back in town yesterday and I was at the airport and a white guy walked up to me and said, I heard you was going to be here. Why are you here? You're not Indian. I said, yes, I am. He said, what tribe? I took off my shoe and said, Blackfoot. It is so nice to be sitting here talking to the original landlords. I knew there was some reason I wasn't paying no rent. But I want you to know I'm 82 years old, but I've been here a long time. Somebody said, how does it feel to be, my grandchild said, how does it feel being 82 years old? I said, feel good. I'm 82, my wife's 75, we don't have a description between the two of us. I said, but the real thing, sometimes you lose your memory when you get this age, huh? But there's nothing wrong with that. Now I can hide my own Easter eggs. I get up every day and meet people who think I know them. And I know they're strangers. But let me just say this to you. I've been in a lot of crowds fighting for human dignity. Sometimes you get depressed. Sometimes you get depressed. But we want them all. That black movement, we took on the mightiest nation in the world with no guns, no bitterness, no evilness, and we won. And let me say to that little pimp punk Snyder, you know why I'm glad he's here today? Because if he go back and spend some of that thug money and get him a researcher and say, pick today's date and how many times have the weather been like this? So you messing with some folks can change the weather, boy. And you talk about you not gonna change your name? Snyder. White folks always make mistakes. Before black folks came here as slaves, no slave in the history of the planet freed themselves in less than 5,000 years. Black folks, they couldn't keep us in bondage 300 years because that dumb white boy came to Africa and thought he was stealing a worker, he was stealing a scientist. I built the pyramid, boy. And I say to you, I guess I didn't know it was something special about me until I realized I live in Plymouth, Massachusetts right now. That's where it started, and I think they might be coming back. I'll be waiting for them this time. My birthday is October the 12th. Columbus Day. And I want Columbus' ancestors to understand he didn't discover America. That punk got lost. I did more to discover America than he did. But look how stupid it is. Columbus discovered America. How can you discover a country that's already occupied? Your car with you in it? So they've been living in this lie for so long, but it's about to come to an end. Don't let nobody sue and make you think that you're insignificant. Don't think you're insignificant because that punk white boy brought some neighbors. Now they're real Indians he brought to the game a couple of weeks ago. They can't help him. Snyder, if you want to be with the real Native man, you should be here. Them folks you had at the game and they in the makeup, they can't determine change. If they could, they could have changed the name. We will change that name. Those of you that's out here will change that name. And don't got nothing to do with his power and his money. If you think power and money make a difference, ask Hitler what happened to him. Ask Napoleon what happened to him. It's not about that. Somewhere, when you understand, my oldest brother, he wanted to be white so bad. He thought that was the real way. He went to all the schools, ended up with about $10 million. He moved out to L.A., moved where the rich white folks lived. L.A., got him a Japanese gardener. He didn't even have no trees. Got him a Mexican nanny. And one day, when the Mexican nannies went on strike about 8 years ago, he had to stay home with the rest of the rich folks to take care of their children, because the nanny said, we won't be there today. And that helped my brother, because until he stayed home with his children, that's the first time he realized they didn't speak English. And so remember this. I had a name that somebody else gave me. Influence. My black mama brought all six of us our toys, and her mind had been so messed up, she told me a white boy brought it to me. So don't try to misunderstand what they do to you. Told me a white boy brought it to me. Then once I got some sense and realized, ain't no white man coming in the ghetto after midnight. And when he get there, he too fat to get through the chimney. Don't get no soot on it. Please, I say to you, change my name. They name me nigga, and they call me boy. Change my name. My name is Change. It's not nigga, it's not boy, it's Mr. Gray. I have 10 children. One of my girls, I named her Miss Gregory. And say, why'd you name her Miss? Because it'd be one black woman on this planet that all white folks would have to call Miss Gregory, because that's her name. So we went from nigger to boy to Mr. President. Out of here, this movement, your time will come. It's here. One day it'll be Mr. or Mrs. and you have to tell what tribe you're from. You be there. The door's already open. Understand that. And so I leave you today and say thank you. I saw something happening that I'd been missing. And Marlon Brando called me one day in the 60s and said, I need to get out to the reservation in Tacoma, Washington. I'm supposed to be there, he said, but I'll be coming late. Would you go? And I went, and my life changed. They put me in jail 9 months to run 9 times consecutively. I said, is that all y'all can do? You ain't got no more power than that. This white boy have no power. The power comes from out there. The sun represents light and the moon represents dark. Snyder and them chumps, they darkness. The CIA, the FBI, the mighty army, it's darkness. Dark have never won out over light. And the only reason the CIA and the FBI and them thugs can carry the power they have is called light. Start getting scared of darkness. I beg you, never be scared of darkness. So somewhere, when you understand, who you are and why we are here. And I just say thank God for you and all the followers and all the people that understand what's going to happen. Snyder, he's here today. Count and see how many bodyguards he bring with him. Then count us and see how many bodyguards we bring with him. Wright don't need to be guarded by Dorothy. I love you. God bless you. Keep living.